Σανκτητοφως δόξα εν υψίς της Θεού και επί γης ειρήνη εν ανθρώπης ευδοκία.
Υμνούμεν σε, ευλογούμεν σε, προσκυνούμεν σε, δοξολογούμεν σε, ευχαριστούμεν σοι, δια την μεγάλη σου δόξα.
Κύριε Βασιλέ, εμπουρανίε Θεέ, Πάτερ Παντοκράτο.
Πρόσδεξε την δέησιν ημών, ο καθήμενος εν δεξιά του Πατρός και ελέησον ημάς.
Στην ημέραν ευλογήσωσε και ενέσω το όνομά σου εις τον αιώνα και εις τον αιώνα του αιώνος.
Καταξίωσα, Κύριε, εν τη ημέρα ταύτη αναμαρτήτως φυλαχτήν ημάς.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε ο Θεός των Πατέρων ημών και ενετών και δεδοξασμένων το όνομά σου εις τους αιώνας.
Αμήν. Γέννητο Κύριε το έλεος σου εφημάς, καθαπεριλπίσαμεν επί σε.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε διδαξών με τα δικαιώματα σου.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε διδαξών με τα δικαιώματα σου.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε διδαξών με τα δικαιώματα σου.
Κύριε καταφυγήν εγεννήθης ημίν, εν γενεά και γενεά εγώ είπα Κύριε, ελέησον με, ίασε την ψυχήν μου ότι ημαρτών.
Κύριε προσε κατεφύγον διδαξών με, του ποιήν το θέλημά σου, ότι σύ ο Θεός μου.
Ότι παρασύ πηγή ζωής εν το φωτί σου οψώμεθα φως.
Παράτηνον το έλεος σου της γήνος κους είσαι, Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος, ελέησον ημάς.
Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος, ελέησον ημάς.
Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος, ελέησον ημάς.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίω Πνεύματι, εν ειν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν.
Άγιος αθάνατος, ελέησον ημάς.
Άγιος ο
Ευλογημένη Βασιλεία του Πατρός και του Υιού και του Άγιου Πνεύματος νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Εν ειρήνη του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν. For the peace from above, for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. Υπέρ της ειρήνης του σύμπαντος κόσμου, στα θεία, στον Άγιον του Θεού Εκκλησίων και της των πάντων ενώσεως του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν. For this holy temple, for those who enter with faith, reverence and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord. Υπέρ του Αρχιεπισκόπου και Πατρός Ιμονιακού του Τιμίου Πριστηρίου της Εγχριστώ Διακονίας, πάντως του κλήρου και του λαού του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν. For the President of the United States, for those in civil authority, for the armed forces, for all the American nation, let us pray to the Lord. Υπέρ της Ιεράς Μετροπόλεως και Νεωριάς Ταύτης και πάσης πόλεως μονής και χώρας και των πιστικών των αναυτές του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν. For seasonable weather, for the abundance of the fruits of the earth, for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. Επλέοντον διπορούντον, αεροπορούντον, ασούντον, καμνόντον, εκμαλώτον, και της σωτηρίας αυτών του Κυρίου δεηθούμεν. For deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Αλληλαβούς όσον ελέησον και διαφύλαξον ημάς ο Θεός της συγχωρείτη. Σπαναγίας ακράντου υπερευλοημένης εν δόξω δεσμίσιμον Θεοτόκου και αεί Πάρθενο Μαρίας, με τα πάντων τραγίου μνημονεύσαντε σε αυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωήν ημών, Χριστού το Θεό παραθούμεθα. Ότι πρέπει εσύ πάσα δόξα, τιμή και προσκύνηση στο Πατρί και το Υιό και το Αγίο Πνεύμα την ίν και αεί, και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αγάπησα ότι σ' ακούσετε, Κύριος της φωνής της δέησεώς μου. Περιέσχομαι οδύνες θανάτου, κινδυνιώδου έβρισαμε. Λέψην και οδύνη νεύρων και το όνομα Κυρίου επικαλέσαμε.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Commemorating our most holy, pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, the Mother of God, and of the Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another in our whole life to Christ our God. Thine is the dominion, thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever into the ages of ages.
Επίστευσα, Δύο ελάλησα, εγώ δε ταπεινώθην σφόδρα. Ανταποδώσω το Κυρίο περί πάντων, όν ανταπέδω και εμείς. Σωτηρίου λείψομαι και το όνομα Κυρίου επικαλέσομαι.
Σπαναγία σακραντού υπερευλαϊμένης εν δόξου δεσποίνης ημών Θεοτόκου και αϊπαρίας με τα πάντων των Αγίου μνημονεύσαντες εαυτούς και αλληλούς και πάσαν την ζωήν ημών Χριστό το Θεό παραθωμεθόν. Ούτι αγαθός και φιλάνθρωπος Θεός υπάρχεις και εσύ την δόξαν αναπέμπωμεν το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Αγίο Πνεύμα την ίν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Εξομολογήστε το Κύριο ότι αγαθώ ότι εις τον αιώνα το έλεος αυτού Αναστασίν πρώτου σου πάθους πιστουμένος εκ νεκρών ηγύρας των Λάζαρων Χριστέ ο Θεός ούθεν και ημείς ως υπέδες τα της νίκης σύμβολα φέροντες
Σοφία ορθή ευλογημένος ο ερχόμενος εν ονόματι Κυρίου Θεός Κύριος και πέφανεν σώσον ημάς Ιε Θεό, ο επί πόλων ουκάς θεστής.
Σαλλοντάς Ι, Αναστασίν πρώτου σου πάθους πιστουμένος εκ νεκρών ηγύρας των Λάζαρων Χριστέ ο Θεός ώθεν και ημείς ως υπέδες τα της νίκης σύμβολα φέροντες σύ τον νικητή του θανάτου.
βαπτίσματος Χριστέ ο Θεός ημών, της αθανάτου ζωής ηξιώθημεν τη Αναστάση.
To the Lord. For thou art God and holy, and to thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever into the ages of ages. O Holy God, rest among thy saints and act glorified by the cherubim and praise by the thrice heard from the thrice holy host. Worship by all the hosts of heaven, thou hast brought all things out of nothingness into being, and thou hast created man in thine own image and likeness, and hast adorned him with all thy favors. Thou who hast given to the wicked the rules of the prudence, and did not neglect the sinner, but ever, and to bring to the adoration and praise due thou, O Master, accept me from the mouth of us sinners. Thrice holy, him and visit us in the righteous and forgive us of all transgressions, voluntary and involuntary, sanctify our souls and bodies, and grant that we may worship thee in holiness all the days of our life. Through the intercessions of the holy Theotokos and of all the saints from the beginning of time, it pleased thee, for thou art good and high. To the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Ευλογημένος ο ερχόμενος εν ονόματι Κυρίου, εξομολογήστε το Κυρίο ότι αγαθός.
Σοφία.
Φιλιππησίους επιστολής Παύλου το ανάγνωσμο.
Προέσκομαι.
Α
αδελφοί, χαίρετε εν Κυρίω πάντοτε, πάλι ερώ χαίρετε. Το επίγες ημών γνωστήτο πάση ανθρώπης, ο Κύριος εγγύς. Μηδέν μεριμνάτε, αλλά εν παντί τη προσευχή και τη δεήση, με τα ευχαριστίας τα αιτήματα ημών γνωριζέστο προς τον Θεόν. Και η ειρήνη του Θεού, υπερέχουσα πάντα νουν, φρουρήσει τες καρδίας ημών και τα νοήματα ημών εν Χριστώ Ιησού. Το λοιπόν, αδελφοί, όσα εστίν αληθή, όσα σεμνά, όσα δίκαια, όσα αγνά, όσα προσφυλή, όσα έφημα, ή της αρετή και ή της έπαινος, τα αυτά λογίζεστε. Και μάθετε και περιλάβετε και οικούσατε και είδετε εν εμή, τα αυτά παράσετε. Και ο Θεός της ειρήνης
attend.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever.
Wisdom.
The reading is from St. Paul's letter to the Philippians.
Let us attend.
Brethren, rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say rejoice. Let all men know your forbearance. The Lord is at hand. Have no anxiety about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, will keep your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brethren, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. What you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, and the God of peace will be with you.
Peace be with you, the readers. Σοφία ορθή ακούσμεν του Άγιου Ευαγγελίου, ειρήνη πάση. Εκ του κατ' ο Ιωάννην Άγιου Ευαγγελίου το ανάγνωσμα προσκομεν. Εξ ημερών του Πάσχα ήλθεν ο Ιησούς εις Βηθανίαν όπου ειν Λάζαρος ο θνεθνικός, ον ήρεν εκ νεκρών, επίησεν ουν αυτό δείπνον εκεί και η Μάρθα δίκονη. Ο δε Λάζαρος ίστον ειν ανεκειμένον συν αυτό, ιούν Μαρία λοβούσα λύτρων μύρου νάρθου, πιστικής πολιτήμου, ήλειψε τους πόδας του Ιησού και εξέμαξε τες τριξήν αυτής τους πόδας αυτού, είδε οικία επληρωθεί εκ της οσμής του μύρου. Λέγει ούν εις εκ των μαθητών αυτού, Ιούδας Σίμωνος Ισκαριώτης, ο μέλλον αυτών παραδιδώνε, διατί τούτο το μύρον ουκ επράθη 300 διναρίων και δόθη πτωχής. Είπε δε τούτο ουκ ότι περί των πτωχών έμελεν αυτό, αλλά ότι κλέπτης ειν και το γλωσσόκομον είχε και τα βαλώματα εβάσταξεν. Είπε νουν ο Ιησούς άφες αυτήν, εις την ημέραν του εντεφιασμού του τετήρηκεν αυτό, τους φτωχούς γαρ πάντοτε έχετε, μεθε αυτόν εμέ δε ου πάντοτε έχετε. Έγνων ουν όκλος πολλής εκ των Ιουδαίων ότι εκεί έστι και ήρθον ουδιά τον Ιησούν μόνον, αλήνετ και τον Λάζαρον είδωσιν, ον έγιρεν εκ νεκρών. Εξουλεύσατε, δε ο αρχηρής είναι και τον Λάζαρον αποκτήνωσιν, ότι πολλοί δι' αυτόν υπήγον των Ιουδαίων και επίστευον εις τον Ιησούν. Τον επαύριον όκλους πολλής, ο ελθόν εις την εορτήν ακούσαντες ότι έρχεται Ιησούς εις Ιεροσόλυμα, έλευον τα βάγια των Φινίκων και εξήλθον εις υπάντησιν αυτό και έκραζον «Οσανά ευλογημένος ο ερχόμενος εν ονόματι Κυρίου Βασιλεύς του Ισραήλ». Εύρον δε ο Ιησούς, ον Άριον εκάθισεν επ' αυτό και καθώς έστι γεγραμμένον «Μη φοβού θύγατερ Σιών, ιδού ο Βασιλεύς σου έρχεται καθήμενος επί πόλων όνου». Ταύτα δε ουκ έγνωσαν οι μαθηταί αυτού το πρώτον, αλ' ότε οδοξάσθη ο Ιησούς, τότε μνήσθησαν ότι ταύτα είναι επ' αυτό γεγραμμένα και ταύτα υπήσαν αυτό. Εμαρτύρι ούν ο όκλος και ούν μετ' αυτού, ότε τον Λάζαρον εφώνησεν εκ του μνημείου και ήρων αυτον εκ νεκρών. Δια τούτο και επίντησεν αυτό όκλος, ότι ούκησον τούτο αυτόν πεπικένε το σημείο. Reading is taken from the Gospel according to St. John. Let us attend. 6 days before Passover, Jesus came to Bethany where Lazarus was, whom Jesus had raised from the dead. And there they made him a supper. Martha served, and Lazarus was one of those at the table with him. And Mary took a pound of costly ointment of pure nard and anointed the feet of Jesus and wiped his feet with her hair. And the house was filled with the fragrance of the ointment. But Judas Iscariot, one of his disciples, the one who was about to betray him, said, "Why was this ointment not sold for 300 denarii and given to the poor?" This he said, not that he cared so much for the poor, but because he was a thief, and as he had the money box, he used to take what was put into it. Jesus said, "Let her alone. Let her keep it for the day of my burial. The poor you always have with you, but you do not always have me." When the great crowd of the Jews learned that he was there, they came not only on account of Jesus, but also to see Lazarus, whom he had raised from the dead. So the chief priests planned to put Lazarus also to death, because on account of him, many of the Jews were going away and believing in Jesus. The next day, a great crowd who had come to the feast heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem. So they took branches of palm trees and went out to meet him, crying, "Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, even the King of Israel." And Jesus found a young donkey and sat upon it. And as it is written, "Fear not, daughter of Zion, behold, your king is coming, sitting on a donkey's colt." His disciples did not understand this at first. But when Jesus was glorified, they then remembered that this had been written of him and had been done to him. The crowd that had been with him when he called Lazarus out of the tomb and raised him from the dead bore witness to this. The reason why the crowd went to meet him was that they heard he had done this sign. That being ever protected by thy power, to thee we may ascribe glory, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages. No one who is bound by the desires and pleasures of the flesh is worthy to approach or draw near. For to serve thee, O King of glory, to serve thee is great and awesome even to the heavenly powers. Yet through thine ineffable and boundless love toward mankind, thou didst unchangeably and immutably become man and served as our high priest, and as Lord of all, has committed to us the celebration of his liturgical and bloodless sacrifice. For thou alone, our Lord, our God, rulest over all things in earth and earth, who art born on the throne of the cherubim, and our Lord, the seraphim, King of Israel, who alone art holy and rests among thy saints. Wherefore implore thee, who alone art good and ready to listen, look down upon me, thy sinful and unprofitable servant. Cleanse my soul and my heart from an evil conscience, and enable me with the power of the Holy Spirit, vessel of the grace of the priesthood, to stand before this thy holy altar. Consecrate thy holy and immaculate body and precious blood, for to thee I come bound. Having bound my head and beseech thee, turn not thy face from me, and even reject me by thy children. But make me worthy, sinful, and unworthy to serve and to offer these gifts unto thee. For thou art the offering accepted, distributed, O Christ our God, and to you ascribe glory together, eternal Father, and life, and the Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Ευλογήσουμε τον Κύριο και εγκαλείεσαι το πνεύμα.
Thank you.
Χριστός μου πάντα την ηχεία ή και έστωσε. Ο Θεός ελάστη μη την παρακολουθήσομενη. Ο Θεός ελάστη μη την παρακολουθήσομενη. Ο Θεός ελάστη μη την παρακολουθήσομενη. Και το στρώσμα πάντα δεν είναι και αγή και στους αιώνας.
Πάντων ημών και πάντων των ευσεβών και ορθοδόξων χριστιανών. Μνηστή Κύριος ο Θεός εν τη βασιλεία αυτού πάντοτε νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. May the Lord our God remember us all in his heavenly kingdom, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Πληρώσομεν την δαΐ συν ημών το Κυρίο. For these precious gifts here presented, let us pray to the Lord. Αντιλαβούς όσον ελέησον και διαφύλαξον ημάς ο Θεός, τη συγχωρητή. Την ημερών πάσαν τελείαν Αγίαν ελληνικήν και αμάρτητον παρά του Κυρίου ετησόμεθον. For an angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord. Συγνώμην και αφεσίν των αμαρτιών και των πλημελημάτων ημών παρά του Κυρίου ετησόμεθον. For things that are good and profitable unto our souls, and for peace in the world, let us ask of the Lord. Τον υπόλοιπον χρόνον της ζωής ημών, και ειρήνη και μετανοή εκτελέσε παρά του Κυρίου ετησόμεθον. The end of our lives may be Christian without pain, blameless and peaceful, and for a good account at the fearful judgment seat of Christ, let us ask of the Lord. Τις Παναγίας ακράντου υπερευλογημένης εν δόξα δεσποίησιμον Θεοτόκου και αι Παρθένο Μαρίας, με τα πάντων των Αγίων μνημονεύσαντες εαυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωήν ημών, Χριστό το Θεό παραθωμεθόν. Διό του νυκτηρμών του μονογενού σου Υιού Μεθού, ευλογητό εσύ συν το Παναγίο και αγαθοκιζοποιώ σου πνεύμα την ίν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Ειρήνη πάση. Let us love one another, that with one mind we may confess. Ο Χριστός εν μέσω ημών ειν και έστι και έστε. Θα στήρας, εν σοφία πρόσκομε.
Πιστεύω εις ένα Θεόν, Πατέρα Παντοκράτορα, ποιητήν ουρανού και γης, ορατών δε πάντων και αοράτων. Και εις ένα Κύριον Ιησού Χριστόν, τον Υιόν του Θεού, τον μονογενή, τον εκ του Πατρός γεννηθέντα προπάντων των αιώνων. Φως εκ φωτός, Θεόν αληθινών εκ Θεού αληθινού, γεννηθέντα, ουποιηθέντα, ομοούσιο το Πατρίδιου τα πάντα εγένετο. Τον δήμας τους ανθρώπους και δια την ημετέραν σωτηρίαν, κατελθόντα εκ των ουρανών και σαρκωθέντα εκ Πνεύματος Αγίου και Μαρίας Παρθένου και ανθρωπίζοντα, σταυρωθέντα τε περιμόν επί ποντίου Πιλάτου και παθόντα και τα φέντα και αναστάντα τη τρίτη ημέρα κατά τας γραφάς. Και ανελθόντα εις τους ουρανούς και κατεζόμενο εκ δεξιών του Πατρός και πάλι ενερχόμενο με τα δόξης, κρίνε ζώντας και νεκρούς, ούτης βασιλείας, ούτε στε τέλος. Και εις το πνεύμα το Άγιον, το Κύριον, το Ζωοποιόν, το εκ του Πατρός εκ παρεμόνρο, το συμπατρί και Υιός προσκυνούμενον και συνδοξαζόμενο, το λαλήσαν διά των προφητών. Εις μίαν Αγίαν, καθολικήν και αποστολικήν εκκλησίαν, ομολογώ εν βάπτισμα εις άφεσιν αμαρτιών, προσδοκώ ανάσταση νεκρών και ζωήν του μέλλοντος αιώνος. Αμήν.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate and suffered and was buried. And he rose on the third day according to the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets. In one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen.
Στόμεν καλό, στόμεν με τα φόβο, πρόσκομεν την Αγία αναφοράν εν ειρήνη προσφέρει. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us lift up our hearts. Let us give thanks unto the Lord. Τον επινίκιον ύμνον άδοντα, φώντα και κραγωτά και λαϊκοντά. These blessed powers, O Master, who loves mankind, and also cry and say, Holy art thou and all holy, by thine only begotten Son and thy Holy Spirit. Holy art thou and all holy, and magnificent is thy glory, who didst unmove the world to come save sinners. And in the night that he was betrayed, or rather surrendered himself for the life of the world, having taken bread in his holy and immaculate and blameless hands, and thanked and blessed and sanctified and broken it, he gave to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, Λόβετε, φάγετε, τούτο μου έστει το σώμα του επέριμον κολλούμενον εις άφεσιν αμάρτιον. Take eat, this is my body, which for you is broken unto remission of sins. Likewise the cup after the supper, saying, Ιετ εξ αυτού πάντες, τούτο εστί το αίμα μου του της καινής διαθήκης, του επίρημον καλόμενον εις άφεσιν αμάρτιον. Drink from it, ye all, this is my blood of the New Testament, which for you and for many is shed unto remission of sins. Therefore, remembering this command of our Savior and all that he endured for us, the cross, the tomb, the resurrection, the third day, the ascension into heaven, the sitting at the right hand, the second in glory is coming again. The soul, φερομέν κατά πάντα και δια πάντα. Again, we offer to thee this reasonable and bloodless worship, and we beseech thee and pray and supplicate thee, send down thy Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts here presented. Make this bread the precious body of thy Christ, and that which is in this cup the precious blood of thy Christ, changing them by the descent of the Holy Spirit. Amen, amen, amen. So that they may be to those who receive them for the purification of the soul, for the remission of sins, for the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, for the fulfillment of the kingdom of heaven, and for the boldness to approach thee neither unto judgment nor unto condemnation. Again, we offer unto thee this reasonable worship for those who have fallen asleep in the faith, forefathers, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, and every righteous spirit made perfect in faith. Ετιδεώμαθα υπέρ ένα πάψεως τας ψυχάς των κοικημένων δούλων σου, δημοσθένου Αντωνίας, Παρασκευής Γεωργίου, Εκατερίνης Βασιλείου, Ιωάννου, Ιωάννου, Ιωάννας και Εκατερίνης. Και ανάπαυσαν αυτούς από σώπα σου. Ξελέτος της Παναγίας Αγράντου, υπερευλογημένης εν δόξω δεσμίσιμον Θεοτόκου και αϊπαρθένου Μαρίας. Ο Θεός μου πάντοτε νυν και αγί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Της μίστη την Κύριε του Αρχιεπισκόπου και Πατρός ημών Ιακώβου, ον χάρισε της Αγίας Εκκλησίας εν ειρήνη ισόν εν ημονιά με κμερεύοντα και ορθού το μόντο των λόγων της εις αληθείας και ον έκαστος κατά διάνοια έχει και πάντων και πασών. And grant us that with one mouth and one heart we may glorify and praise thine honorable and majestic name, of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of our great God, Savior, Jesus Christ, shall be with you all. Having commemorated all the saints again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. For these precious gifts which have been offered and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord. That our merciful God, who hath received them on his holy and celestial and invisible altar unto a scent of spiritual fragrance, may send down upon us divine grace, the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray. Την ενότητα της πίστεως και την κοινωνία του Άγιου Πνεύματος ετισάμενοι αυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωή ημών, Χριστό το Θεό παραθωμεθά. Και καταξίωσον ημάς, Δέσποτε, με την Παρησία σαν κατακρίτως τολμάν επικαλείστε σε τον επράνιον Θεόν Πατέρα, και λέγει, Πάτερ ημών, ο εν της ουρανής, αγιαστεί το όνομά σου, έλθε το η βασιλεία σου, γεννηθεί το το θέλημά σου, ως εν ουρανό και επί της γης. Τον άρτον ημών των επίουσιων, δώσει μην σήμερον, και άφεση μην τα αφιλήματα ημών, ως και εμείς αφήμεν σε φιλέτης ημών, και εμείς εν έγκυς ημάς πειρασμών, αλλά ρίσσε ημάς από το πονηρού. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Ειρήνη πάση. Σκεφαλός ημών το Κύριο κλείνομεν. Through the grace and mercy and love for mankind of thine only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed together with thine all holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Προσκομεν τ' Άγια της Αγίες. Μιλίζεται και δημερίζεται ο μνός του μεδομιδοζόμενος, ο πάντοτε αισθηρούμενος, πάντοτε αισθιόμενος και με δεπανόνος οριόντος αγιάζον. Λίλο μου πατερίου πίστεως πνεύματος Αγίου. Ευλογημένη ζέσον έτσι Κύριε πάντοτε νύν και αεί και στους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν ζέσεις πίστης πλήρης πνεύματος Αγίου. That thou art verily the Christ, the Son of the living God, who didst come into the world to save sinners. Also we believe that this is thy sacred body and this is thy precious blood. Therefore we pray to thee, have mercy upon us and pardon our transgressions, voluntary and involuntary, in word and deed, both known and unknown. And make it worthy to partake of thy sacred mysteries unto the remission of sins and unto life eternal.
Behold, we approach for Holy Communion according to the and of partake for our hearts. Receive us today, O Son of God, as partake of the mission of the Spirit, which is the Jesus Christ. Tremble and mourn, but honor divine blood. For it is a light of cold, but in your name, the Son. But the Spirit of the Lord, so on. Into magnificence of his saints, how shall we, the heirs of the Lord, receive us today, O Son of God, who is partaking of thy mystical faith, and not of his community, and not of his Judas, but as of heaven, and of his kingdom. O Theos, elasti mi te marathon kleisomen. O Theos, elasti ti mi te marathon kleisomen. O Theos, elasti mi te marathon kleisomen. Adhevi amon, chers of dem, adhevi amon, 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 Έτι μετά τη δοθέμη του Μαθαίου των Αξίου ήρμαν αυτό τίμη και πράγιον. Σώμα εις άφηση μαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. Έτι μετά τη δοθέμη του Μαθαίου των Αξίου ήρμαν αυτό τίμη και πράγιον. Έμα εις άφηση μαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. Εις το όνομα του Πατρός. Αμήν και του Υιού. Αμήν και του Αγίου Πνεύματος. Αμήν. Τούτο έλειψε η γερμανή μου καθαρή.
Με το φόβο θεοπίστεως και αγάπης προσέρθετε.
Με την ουράνια ιδωλή του Θεού, εξάφησε μαρτυριών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. Λαμβάνει η δουλειά του Θεού, Καϊώτη, εις άφηση αμαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. Μεταλαμβάνει η δουλειά του Θεού, εις άφηση αμαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. Μεταλαμβάνει ο δούλος του Θεού, σε μαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. Μεταλαμβάνει η δούλη του Θεού, σ' άφησε μαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. Μεταλαμβάνει η δούλη του Θεού, σ' άφησε μαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν.
με τα λαμβάνει η δούλη του Θεού. Μαρία, εις άφηση μαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. The servant of God. Of her sins, of her life everlasting. Servant of God, for the mission of her sins, of her life everlasting. Servant of God, the one you do to the Uniki Savsumathion, Kesuin, Union, Amin. Servant of God, for the mission of her sins, of her life everlasting. Servant of God, of her sins, of her life everlasting. Servant of God, come closer. For the mission of her sins, of her life everlasting. Servant of God, for the mission of her sins, of her life everlasting. Lady is absent of the young, Kesuin, Union, Amin. Servant of God, of his sins, of her life everlasting. Ani dhuli du Theu, Sophia Sams Martion, Kesuin, Union Amin, servant of God, the mission of his sins, of her life everlasting. Adalavani dhuli du Theu, Sophia Sams Martion, Kesuin, Union Amin, Adalavani dhulus du Theu. Σάβησε Μαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. Με τραβάνει η δούλη του Θεού.
Ελευθερία.
Ελευθερία. Σάβησε Μαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. Servant of God. Είναι ο δούλος του Θεού. Σάβησε Μαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. Servant of God. Of his sins, of her life everlasting. Servant of God, of her life everlasting. The servant of God, of her sins, of her life everlasting. And the Lavanya Idulu to Theum. Maria Sabsimation, Kesuin, Union, Amin. Servant of God, mission of his sins, of her life everlasting. The Vanya Dulus to Theo. Salve Matyon, Kesuin, Ilion, Amin. Servant of God. Medalavani Duli to Theo. Samadion, Kesuin, Ionion, Amin. Servant of God, Eulius, Skinian for the mission of his sins, of her life of his. Servant of God, Christus, Skinian for the mission of his sins. Servant of God. Servant of God, Eleftheria. Servant of God, Eulia. For the mission of her sins, of her life, of Augustine. The servant of God, Λαμβάνει η δουλή του Θεού. Δημήτρα. The servant of God. Close your mouth. The servant of God. The servant of God. sinners, and for life everlasting. Servant of God, for remission of our sins. Servant of God, for the remission of his sins, and for life everlasting. The servant of God, Vasiliki, for the remission of her sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, for the remission of her sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, close your mouth. Servant of God. Servant of God. Servant of God. Excommunicated for the remission of our sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God. Excommunicated for the remission of our sins. Servant of God. Ave Salve. Excommunicated for the remission of our sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, Blessed Nikki is commended for the mission of our sins of our life everlasting. The servant of God, Anastasia is commended for the mission of our sins. The servant of God, Anastasia is commended for the mission of his sins of our life everlasting. The servant of God is commended for the mission of her sins. Με τα λαμβάνια η δούλη του Θεού. Servant of God. For the mission of our sins and for life everlasting. Με τα λαμβάνια η δούλη του Θεού. Εις άφησιν μαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. Servant of God. For life everlasting. The servant of God, Eleni, is commended for the remission of her sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, Eleni, is commended for the remission of her sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, Eleni, is commended for the remission of his sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, for the mission of our sins and life everlasting. The servant of God, for the mission of our sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, Athanasia. Servant of God, is commended for the remission of his sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, Christos, is commended for the remission of his sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, Ananias, is commended for the remission of her sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, Alexandros, is commended for the remission of his sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, for the mission of her sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, is commended for the mission of her sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, is commended for the mission of her sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, sins of her life everlasting. The servant of God, is commended for the remission of his sins of her life everlasting. The servant of God, is commended for the remission of his sins of her life everlasting. The Ευαγγέλιο του Θεού. Σάφησε μαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. Servant of God, speak of the mission of our sin, of our life everlasting. Servant of God, you do us to Theo. Sanctus in Amartion, Kesuin, Ionion, Amin. Servant of God, Constantinos is communion for the remission of his sins, of our life everlasting. The servant of God, servant of God, the sins of her life everlasting. The servant of God, the of her sins of her life everlasting. The servant of God, the of her sins of her life everlasting. Servant of God, for the remission of his sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, for sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, for the remission of her sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, for the remission of his sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, Israel's communion for the mission of his sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, his communion for the mission of our sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, his communion for the mission of her sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, Constantinos, his communion for the mission of his sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, Ioannis is communion for the remission of his sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, Alexandros is communion for the remission of his sins and for life everlasting. And Ioannis to Theu, Safis in Amartion, Kezrin, Ionion, Amin. Servant of God, remission of his sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, remission of our sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, remission of his sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, Constantinos is commune for the remission of his sins. The servant of God, for the remission of his sins for life everlasting. The servant of God, mission of his sins and for life everlasting. Christos is office of Martion, Kesrin, Ionion, Amin. Servant of God. This guy's getting taller or what? Servant of God. Servant of God. Of his sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, Elizabeth is communion for the remission of her sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, Alexandra is communion for the remission of her sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, communion for the remission of his sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, Athanasios is commune for the mission of his sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God is commune for the mission of her sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God is commune for the mission of her sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, Ioannis is commune for the remission of his sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, Fortinius, commune for the mission of her sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, Fortinius, conviction of his sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God. That's it. His commune for the remission of her sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God. His commune for the remission of her sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God. Constantinos. His commune for the remission of his sins and for life everlasting. Constantinos. His commune for the remission of his sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, Hierasimos, his commune for the remission of his sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, Iodios, his commune for the remission of his sins and for life everlasting.
Sos ο Θεός των λαών σου και ευλογήσον την κληρονομία σου.
Πάντοτε νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Let us rise, having partaken of the divine, holy, pure, immortal, heavenly, life-giving, and awesome mysteries of Christ. Worthily let us give thanks unto the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Giving us the Lord, that this whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us complete ourselves and commend ourselves and one another and all our life to Christ our God. Ότι εσύ ο Αγιός μας ημών και εσύ την δόξαν εν απέμπωμεν, το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύμα την ειν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Ειν ειρήνη προέλθωμεν του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν. Ο ευλογώντες ευλογούνται σε Κύριε και αγιάζοντες υπηπιθώτας όσον το λαόν σου και ευλόγησον την κληρονομία σου. Το πλήρωμα της Εκκλησίας σου φύλαξον, αγίασον τους αγαπώνεστε πρέπειαν του οίκου σου. Σύ αυτούς αντιδόξασον τη γράμμη και μη εγκαταλείψη μας σου ελπίζοντας επί σε. Ειρήνη του κόσμου σου δώρησε, της Εκκλησίας σου της ιερεύση της άρουψην ημών, το στρατό και μπαντή το λαό σου. Ότι πάσα δώσεις αγαθή και πάντορμα τέλειον, άνος έστι καταβαίνουν εξού του Πατρός των Φώτων. Και εσύ τη δόξαν και ευχαριστίαν και προσκύνησαν να πέμπωμεν τον Πατρί και του Υιό και του Αγίου Πνεύμα την ειν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Κινήν Αναστάσιν πρώτους ουπάθους πιστουμένος, εκ νεκρών ηγύρας των μαζάρων Χριστέ ο Θεός. Ούθεν και ημίς ως υπέδες τα της νίκης συμβόλα φέροντες, συν το νικητή του θανάτου βόμεν, χωσάνα εν της ύψιστης, ευλογημένος ο ερχόμενος, εν ονόματι Κυρίου.
Του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Κύριε ο Θεός ημών, ο καθήμενος επί των χειροβήμ και εξεγείρας, τη δυναστείαν και αποστήλας του μονογενήσου Υιόν των Κύριων ημών Ιησούν Χριστόν, είναι σώσει τον κόσμον διά του Σταυρού, της Ταφής και της Αναστάσεως αυτού, ου παραγενωμένου εν Ιερουσαλήμ επί το ακούσιο πάθος ο λαός ο καθήμενος εν σκότη εν σκιά θανάτου, λαβώντες τα της νίκης σύμβολα τους κλάδους των δέντρων και τα βάγια των φοινίκων, την Ανάστασιν προεμήνησαν, αυτός δέσποτα και ημάς, τους κατά μίμησιν εκείνον την προεόρτιο ταύτη ημέρα, ευλόγησονταν βάγια και κλάδων δέντρων, εν χερσί φέροντας, διατήρησον και ως εκείνοι οι όκλοι και οι παιδες, το σανά σύ προσφέροντες διαφύλαξον. Όπως εν ύμνης και ουδές πνευματικές καταξιωθόμεν και ζωπιού τη τριημέρο Αναστάσιος εν Χριστώ Ιησού του Κυρίου ημών. Let us pray to the Lord. O Lord our God, who sits upon the cherubim, you have revealed your sovereign power by sending your only begotten Son, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, to save the world through his cross, his burial, and his resurrection. And when he came to Jerusalem to suffer his voluntary passion, the people who sat in darkness and the shadow of death took boughs of trees and branches of palms as symbols of victory, thus foreshadowing the resurrection. Do you yourself, O Master, keep and protect all of us who on the eve of the feast bear palms and branches, and we ask that you bless these palms in imitation of them, and like the crowds of those we cry, Hosanna, to you, so that through spiritual hymns and songs we may found worthy the life-giving resurrection on the third day in Jesus our Lord, with whom you are blessed, together with all holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. To Kyrie eleison. Ευλογία Κύριου και ελέος αυτού ευθυμάστη αυτού Θεία χάρητη και ανθρωπία πάντοτε νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Δόξα Σύ ο Θεός ελπίσιμον Κύριε δόξα Σύ.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίω Πνεύματι και νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Πάτερ Άγιε ευλόγησον.
Ο επί πόλου όνε καθεστήνε δε καταδεξάμενε ως διά την ημών σωτηρίαν, ο Αναστάς εκ νεκρών Χριστός ο Ρυθρός Θεός ημών, τες πρεσβείας της Παναχράντου και Παραμού Μαγείας αυτού Μητρός, δυνάμει του Τιμίου και Εζώπιου Σταυρού, προστασίας του Τιμίου Πουρανίων Δυνάμενου Σωμάτων, ηκεσίας του Τιμίου Ενδόξου Προφήτου Προδρόμου και Βαπτιστού Ιωάννου, των Αγίων Ενδόξων και Καρπίνων Αποστόλων, των Αγίης Πατέρων ημών Μεγάνων Ιωκών Ιωπικών Δασκάλων, του Αγίης Πατρός ημών Ιωάννου Αρχιεπισκόπου Κωνσταντινοπόλεως του Χρυσοστόμου, των Αγίων Ενδόξων Καλλινίκων Μαρτύρων, των Οσίγων Θεοφόρων Πατέρων ημών, των Αγίων Κυδικαίων Θεοπατρών Ιωακήμ και Άνιης, των Αγίων Αγάφου, Ρούφου, Φλέγοντας, Αστικρήτου, Ηρωδίωνος και Έρμου των Αποστόλων, Καλεστίνου Επισκόπου Ρώμης, Ιωάννου Νεομάρτυρος και πάντων των Αγίων Ελέης και σώσε εμάς, ως αγαθός και φιλάνθρωπος και ελεήμων Θεός. Διοφόντρα Υιόν Πατέρων ημών, Κύριε Ιησού Χριστέ ο Θεός,
eleison και σώσον ημάς. Η Αγία Τριάστη φυλάξτε πάντες ημάς. Καλημέρα σας και χρόνια σας πολλά.
Good morning, and a happy Palm Sunday to all of us. And this is a day of joyous celebration as our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ makes his way into the great capital city of Jerusalem, and where he was looked upon as the Savior and the individual who would come and ease the pain of the long-suffering Jews and the people who were oppressed. And as, of course, we know, the story that goes on is their great disappointment, in looking upon Jesus as a conqueror, but they wanted a conqueror with might, with power, with force. And of course, Jesus was completely, of course, the opposite. We begin our services this coming evening at 7 o'clock with the Nymphios service, the service of the bridegroom, and all of our services are listed in our bulletin for you to read and to see, and hopefully participate in as many as you are able. Please look through the schedule of services carefully to make sure that you have the times and the days correct. We also want to bring to your attention the fact of our consecration that will be taking place on Sunday, May 6th, and the deadline for the various patron book and the like is coming up, I believe, on the 10th of April, so those that are wishing to be a part of that. The consecration is the service of the baptism of our chapel of St. Catherine's, of which so many thousands and thousands of children have been educated throughout the 6 decades that St. Catherine's has been in existence and the chapel has been in existence. And on Sunday, May 6th, will be the consecration of the chapel of St. Catherine's. It is a moving service, it is a beautiful service. It is one which the holy relics will be placed into the altar on the newly consecrated altar of St. Catherine's on this day. So please read the material inside your bulletin and hopefully you will be able to be a part of this celebration and of this joy. So many of you, I'm sure, have gone through the ranks and the years as Sunday school children, and if not you, then your children or even your grandchildren have done that. So it is it's a joyous event for the parish of Panagias. His Eminence will be leading us in the consecration on this day with select other clergy. At the end of my sermon, we will be having the Ladies Philoptico Society come forward to have what we call an ectacto disco, a special tray which will be for the collection for flowers for the epitaphio. So that will be at the conclusion of my sermon, so please we ask and the ladies ask that you contribute and be generous for that so that we may prepare for Friday evening's lamentation and epitaphio service. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Palm Sunday for Jesus Christ marked the turning point in a long journey. A journey not long in years, because it was a 3-year journey which Christ made, but it was a long and a meaningful trip and journey with Christ here on earth. And on this day, Jesus stood on the threshold of a coming week that literally would change the entire world and turn the world upside down. And this day for us Orthodox Christians is a day that's divided into two. Our morning service, where we see joy, we see palms, and we see the songs and the hymns of our chanters and our choirs, one of being upbeat, where Christ enters Jerusalem to a cheering crowd who joyously proclaim him as King. And then immediately this evening, where that same crowd turns suddenly angry, ugly, and hateful. Jesus and his disciples stood at a vantage point that morning overlooking the city of Jerusalem. And Jerusalem could be seen where they were standing from miles all around. And the city seemed so peaceful from a distance. And from this vantage point, Jesus realized that the end of his earthly ministry was soon approaching. And he told his followers, "The hour has come." So Jesus instructed 2 of his disciples to go into a nearby village, where they would find a donkey colt that had never been ridden before. And Jesus told them, "Untie it and bring it back here. And if someone asks why you are taking the colt, simply tell them the Lord needs it."
And with that assurance, the two disciples set out in their search for the colt, as Jesus had told them to do. Imagine their surprise. Imagine their joy when they found the colt just as Jesus said they would. And sure enough, as they were beginning to take it and start walking away, someone questioned them. What are you doing? Why are you taking this colt? And the disciples replied as Jesus had instructed them, and they were allowed to walk away with this colt without any further questions. We can notice, first of all, the high hopes of those who accompanied Jesus into the city. No sooner had the two disciples returned with the colt, a crowd then began to appear. And the crowd was in the mood for a celebration. There was excitement in the air. And our gospel reading tells us that some people began to spread their cloaks on the ground, while others climbed up into trees, palm trees, and were cutting the branches down, and they began to place them in front as Christ went by and he was sitting on the donkey. And there was singing and shouting, and the people, it seemed, were ready for a change. They wanted someone to lead them to a better life. But the problem with their high hopes was that they were short-sighted. They could not see the world from God's perspective, for God had a greater plan, a grander plan than they could ever imagine. When the people along the way saw Jesus riding a colt approaching Jerusalem, they immediately thought that Jesus would enter the city and begin to smash, to batter, to break up the established order that they were subjected to for so many years. They thought it would be a showdown between Jesus and the Roman officials. This was what they wanted. This was what they were hoping for. Hosanna, blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord, rang out from everywhere as Jesus entered the city. And Hosanna can be translated perhaps as save us now. In other words, the people were geared up and ready for change. Yet as we know, Jesus' action was a contradiction of what the people had hoped for. Jesus was riding a donkey colt, a symbol of peace. He wasn't riding a horse, which traditionally is the symbol of conquering. Look at the icon of St. Demetrius. Look at the icon of St. George, where they are soldiers, and the horse connotes conquering, war. Jesus entered the city seated on a donkey colt, the symbol of peace. Jesus approached Jerusalem in peace as a humble servant and not a warrior king. And the people were so preoccupied with the notion of political and economic power that they were blind as to what was taking place before them and what the purpose of Jesus was. Yes, God was at work, but not the way the people were hoping for. And our churches work much in the same manner. Because we work for the church, each of us forms an opinion of how and what the church should represent. Should it be primarily a political vehicle? Should it be an ethnic and a cultural club? Should it be an environmental advocate or a human rights machine? Should it be for missionary outreach or a social or an athletic organization? Oftentimes, our views differ from the true mission of the church, which is first and foremost, and primarily, to bring the faith closer to God and to assist them in their quest for salvation and eternal life. All of the rest comes after, is secondary, if important at all. All of our other activities as a church community simply add to our existence as a church family. God is at work even when we are not aware of it. The people at that first Palm Sunday were looking for what? They were looking for a conquering king. And while Jesus appreciated the people's high praises and hopes, he knew very well that these hopes were short-sighted and was not the true mission of God. Because God had a different plan, a plan that would change the world forever. And this brings us, my dear brothers and sisters, to the final thing to be said for this Palm Sunday. It's very easy to shout and demand, but it is much harder to serve. You may remember bumper stickers that had come out many years ago that read, "Honk if you love Jesus." And then there was a follow-up one, "Tithe if you love, because anyone can honk." But what does that mean? Everyone loves a parade. Everyone loves to get excited. And sometimes we too get caught up in the excitement of the moment. And we are filled with great enthusiasm, a fresh burst of energy over a particular project or a cause. Unfortunately, many times, as we are human beings, our enthusiasm soon fades and we lose interest. So it's easy to shout. However, it's hard, even harder, to serve. And so our gospel reading on this Palm Sunday tells us just that. It is easy to shout, it's easy to demand, but it's hard to serve. What the people who welcomed Jesus into Jerusalem that day did not realize was that God was offering them an opportunity to join him in doing a new thing. Rather than simply smashing the oppressive government of that day, God was beginning at the bottom up to build a whole new world order. And he was starting with a small group of men and women, a grassroots spiritual army, so to speak, that would grow person by person through the ages until it transcended all the governments of this world. The grassroots army today are called you and I, Christians, followers of the word of Jesus Christ, now numbering in the hundreds of millions and still growing. So if we ever become confused about the relevance of Jesus Christ, the relevance of his church, and the purpose of the Passion, Holy Week, and Pascha, and Easter, let us remember Palm Sunday and why we are shouting Hosanna this morning. It's because Jesus is alive, and he is leading, still leading, his army of followers until that day when oppression is no more and everyone lives in dignity and peace and freedom together under the lordship of Jesus Christ. Remember, it's easy to shout, it's easy to demand, but what our Lord really needs are people willing to serve. And perhaps we also need to refocus as to why we attend church, why we choose to serve a church, and what our motives and values are all about. How do they match up with what Jesus expects, especially as we walk these days of the week of Passion? And during this coming week, each year every priest from the pulpit cries out and asks our people to look at this Holy Week and to use these holy services to reflect and to examine and to prepare ourselves for the greatest sacrifice that ever has or ever will be done for us. Our services this Holy Week is to experience our Lord's journey, where he is exposed to betrayal, humiliation, defense, sacrifice, and ultimately his death and glorious resurrection. All done for us. in order that we may be saved. On behalf of our members of the parish council and my co-worker, Father Athanasios, we wish you a blessed Holy Week, and to everyone, a Kalo Pascha. Amen. We ask that our ladies come forward now to pass our third and final tray, which is specifically earmarked for our flowers for later in the week. And as well, there will be members of the parish council that will be passing out our stewardship information for those who have not as yet pledged for the year 2012.